Okay, wow, it's always such a pleasure to welcome back James and his incredible band to our stage. I gotta tell you, James has done so many little things for us on the side. He's been a supporter of TCAM for so many years. What a great friend for us. Are you guys ready for some blues? Are you ready for some blues? Let's give a big time welcome to an American blues legend. Let's hear it for the James Montgomery Band.
again on guitar.
That's the amazing David Hall, the bass guitar, ladies and gentlemen. And the incredible Jeff Thompson, thanks for the warm welcome. TK, thank you.
You gotta stay hydrated in this weather, boy. I'm under strict orders from my mother.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
The response was overwhelming.
So check it out, you know, this is actually one of our favorite places to play in the whole United States of America. And I mean, everybody. We love T-Chan. So check it out, you all know Grace Kelly. Grace Kelly, the wonderful saxophone player who we started working with when she was 13 years old. Well, you know, she had a house in Dover here, you know, for a little while. She was living right here in Dover, Massachusetts. So then George and I over there one day with Grace. And we're sitting around, having a great time, and we said, hey, you know, we're all here. Why don't we write a song? So me and George and Grace sat down and wrote a song that goes like this.
Check it out, Charlie.
tell you, we all have records out. Everyone in the band has records available here tonight. And I can't help but reflect and think what lovely Labor Day gifts they would make for those of you who have been on Labor Day. Since we don't get Sally's for Labor Day. Well, we're like a regular Target here tonight. We all have like CDs and merchandise and all that stuff. So check it out. Our last studio album was called From Detroit to the Delta. Detroit to the Delta. We got Johnny Winter on the record. From Aerosmith. We got Brad Whitford and Joey Kramer on the record. From the Rolling Stones band, the Jay Giles band, yes, even the James Brown band, we have the Uptown Horns on the record. My best friend in show business, I've known him since I was 16 years old. He calls me son, I call him dad. When I call him up, his wife goes, your father wants to say hello. Blues legend James Cotton is on the CD. Did I mention Johnny Winter's on the CD? I think I did. From the rap group, Run DMC. The seminal rap group, DMC is on the CD. I'm actually rapping a song with DMC. So in fact, you're looking at a rap artist right here. So check it out, it's called From Detroit to the Delta. I was born in Detroit, Michigan. Think of a more wonderful place to spend a vacation. At the airport, they sell Kevlar. It's unbelievable. You know? It's like, okay, I feel, call me a cab. I got my Kevlar. It's unbelievable. Detroit to the Delta. I was born in Detroit, Michigan. I made a movie with Morgan Freeman. When the movie was over, Morgan Freeman insisted. He said, when was the last time you're down in the Deep South? And I toured down in the Deep South with Lynyrd Skynyrd and Marshall Tucker and the Allman Brothers. You know, he'd be in town for a night and leave the next day. I said, Morgan, I've never been down to Clarksdale, Mississippi. So he had us down to Clarksdale, Mississippi. We got blues fans who know about Clarksdale, right? Clarksdale, Mississippi. Where Robert Johnson walked. Where Charlie Patton walked. Where Muddy Waters walked. Where John Lee Hooker walked. Where James Cotton walked. Where Ike Turner walked. They all walked the streets of Clarksdale. It was like a pilgrimage to the Holy Land. Actually, it was just a lot of fun. But anyway, one of the great things about staying at Morgan Freeman's place, it's directly across the street from the shack where Muddy Waters was born and raised. Muddy Waters, arguably the most important figure in the history of American music, just ask the Beatles and the Rolling Stones. So check it out, it's great. You get up in the morning, you get a cup of coffee, you walk across the street. Muddy Shack. We were so impressed by that that we decided we would play our favorite slow blues song by Muddy Waters. A little thing called Same Thing goes like this here. So there we are, I'm looking at Muddy Shack. When we found out that Billy Gibbons from ZZ Top took a plank off of that shack and made a guitar out of it, and you can see that missing plank, by the way. We sit there ourselves, Now, what would ZZ Top do if they played that same slow Muddy Waters song you just heard? So we took Same Thing by Muddy Waters, and we ZZ Topped it, and we came up with this here.
I see the same thing.
the set list already. Don't worry.
Absolutely.
We're having such a great time. We just threw the set list away, and we're just going to make this stuff up as we go along. Yeah. Anyway. So check it out. I had the wonderful opportunity to spend five, almost 6 years with the Johnny Winter Band. And Johnny was the most unique person I've ever met in this business. And believe me, you know, I spent New Year's Eve with Mick Jagger. And the night I met Bruce Springsteen, he sold 75 tickets. So I've met a lot of people. Johnny Winter, most unique guy ever. Tell my niece of it. But check it out. I do want everyone to know that Johnny was in great health his last 5 years. Really the best health, best years of his life. Everyone says, well, Johnny was so frail. He was for a while, but I want to set the record straight. The last 5 years, he was in great shape. He stopped doing the prescription drugs. He stopped drinking, stopped smoking cigarettes. The day when I found out that Johnny stopped smoking pot, I started buying all sorts of non-perishable items. I stocked up in gallons and gallons of water. I even bought a lot of those kidney beans, you know, just hoping that one day that would. Anyway, but he stopped doing all that stuff. He recorded with Joe Bonamassa, recorded with Eric Clapton, recorded with Susan Tedeschi, recorded with Dr. John, recorded with Derek Trucks, recorded with Carlos Santana, and the list goes on and on. So just want to set the record straight. Johnny was in great shape his last 5 years, no question about it. So anyway, when we lost Johnny, we lost someone who I thought was the greatest slide guitar player on the planet. I think there's four of them left. We got Bonnie Raitt. We got Sonny Landis. We got Derek Trucks. And we got George McKinney. Best in the business in the house tonight. So I wrote this song for Johnny when I was still in his band. But don't pay attention to me. Just watch George the Sly guitar work on this thing. This is going out to you, Johnny. I love you. Check it out.
Go little Johnny, play that slide guitar. Go little Johnny, play that slide guitar. If you were just a kid and everybody knew would be a star. Start little fool, my world, little devil, you were playing in the band. My title for whatever, you come someday, he would be the best by far. If you just took down little Johnny on the slide guitar. Before he was 12, he was even a show. They were playing little Johnny on the radio.
Presentation from his CD, I will say that 2006, 2009, 2011, 2013, if you'd have seen certain Aerosmith tours, David would have been the bass player playing with that band on that board. Not a band member, we want to make sure. Tommy Hamilton, we just saw Tommy Hamilton last week, greatest guy in the history of the world. But every once in a while, so I'll tell you more about Dave, more, but David Hall, ladies and gentlemen.
All right. Y'all don't mind if I move over to this mic for a second, right? Okay. Here's my question. Question number two of the evening. How many soul music lovers in this room? Me too. So we're going to play a little soul music for you. This is a song that's on my CD, which is available here tonight. And this is called Pay Some Attention.
Pay some attention to me.
Ocean. A lot of great tunes on that CD. Check it out. Dave Hall, Lee.
Thank you, Soul Lovers. All right. Thank you, thank you. You're a very discriminating individual. All right, you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna keep that groove right where it belongs, right where it is, right now. Here we go.
Cards made to fall on the foundation. Paul played it.
got to find my baby if it takes all night. When you're by yourself, yeah, what a lonesome feeling. When you're by yourself, and the one that you're loving has gone on with someone else. Well, you know I love you, baby.
This band in 1979.
1969 in Cambridge, Massachusetts. Right before any of you in this room were born, we started the band.
Oh, don't kill me now.
Don't even try. Check it out. Back then, we were straight ahead, unadulterated, unexpurgated. Got a degree in English from Boston University. Unexpurgated. An unedited blues band. So tonight we're going to play a song that we learned from Paul Butterfield. At least I did when I was 17 years old. Been playing it ever since. Straight ahead blues. Detroit style. We're going to do this Detroit. The difference between, I always get asked this, what's the difference between Detroit blues and Chicago blues? Very similar. But Detroit blues is greasy. So check it out, Detroit style from the A.
Thank you.
Jeff Beck! Thank you.
bass guitar. My good friend Jeff Thompson on the drums. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. So honored. Thank you. Set me up nicely, like a great blues band that they are. Thanks so much.
Geez, George, now that you seem to have won the crowd over, maybe you should play one of your own songs.
What a great idea, James. How did you ever think of that?
Because it was in the set list for the last 6 months. I think that's what happened.
Is here as well, isn't it? Coincidental, yes.
Labor Day gift.
I know I labored a lot to finish it, so.
So you gotta check out both David and Jordan's CD. They're both great. Honestly, I have them both myself. They're in my car. Any CD that I listen to is always in my car, so I get their CDs in my car. I love these guys. They're great players. Listen to the song that George wrote. And it's going to also be on our upcoming CD that's going to be released any minute now.
Another coincidence.
Last night I went walking.
Come on, thanks. James Montgomery, ladies and gentlemen.
So I'd say we got some other great friends in the house tonight. We got a whole dressing room full of people down there. Wait till the clowns come up and you know, we're gonna bring you outside. There's a Volkswagen out there. It's unbelievable. So check it out. You know, when I was getting started in this business in Boston, I started my first band. I started in 1965 in high school, and my high school band, we opened for Iggy Pop and the MC5, so we did okay. Wow. And we got compared to Frank Zappa and the Mothers of Invention. But that was, the name of the band was the Montgomery Miller Blues Band. I took LSD my junior year and changed the name of the band overnight to The Great Cosmic Expanding. Now that was the band that got compared to Frank Zappa, not the Montgomery Miller Blues Band. But anyway, all I'm saying is that, you know, we've been doing this for a long time. But when I first moved to Boston, there was a guy there who took me under his wing and kind of showed me everything. Well, I was a student at BU and had a dormitory band with Skunk Baxter from the Doobie Brothers and Steely Dan. We had a little dormitory band. But if it hadn't been for this guy, because this guy really showed me how to put a band together. Showed me how to, you know, make wise choices in hiring musicians, and obviously he taught me well. Yes. He's in the house tonight, and without this guy, I'm not sure that I would be in show business today. So can we welcome, please, my dear friend, my mentor, and the guy who taught me, Tyler, you're out there, Tyler Morris, ladies and gentlemen. Without this guy, I have no idea if I would even be in show business today. If it weren't for you. If it weren't for Tyler Morris. Tyler Morris, ladies and gentlemen. So anyway, you know, we're going to follow Tyler on this, and you start it out, and I'll bring up our next special guest. So start it out. Thank you.
Hit the road, Jack. Hit the road, Jack. Hit the road, Jack. And don't you come back. Hit the road, Jack. Hit the road, Jack. Hit the road, Jack. Hit the road, Jack. And don't you come back. Hit the road, Jack.
But no more, no more, no more.
Who do you love?
even doesn't find out what the gig is until thank you. guitar, our teacher, the guy who showed us everything we know. Give it up. From right here in Medfield, Massachusetts. Give it up. Tyler Morris on the guitar. On the bass guitar. From the Buddy Miles Band. From the Joe Cocker Band. Always a member of the Joe Perry Project, and every once in a while can be seen on stage playing bass for Aerosmith. Give it up. David Hall on the bass guitar. On the drums, my main man, he holds it down every night. Play with Bellevue Cadillac. In the house tonight. Plays with the Blues Brothers with Dan Aykroyd and Jim Belushi. Played in one of Steven Tyler's solo bands. But my favorite story. A couple years ago, we had Steven Stills in our band. Yeah, that guy, Steven Stills. So during George's first solo, Steven never heard him play before. During George's first solo, Steven Stills comes up to me while we're playing. He goes, James, he says, what'd you say the name of the guitar player was again? And I'm yelling at him, we're playing. I'm going, Steven, his name is George McCann. And Steven Stills goes like this, he goes, well, George McCann is scaring the hell out of me. Let's welcome the guitar players in the house tonight. From Ashland, Massachusetts. Give it up.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen. We had a great time tonight. See you next time. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for James Montgomery. Give it up. Put your hands together. Give it up. James Montgomery, ladies and gentlemen.
So the band doesn't really want to come back here and play with me, so I guess I'm just going to tell some jokes for a while. We have a couple that are filthy and a couple that are clean.
And what do you want for Labor Day?
I didn't hear that because I'm deaf, but I kind of think that I'm glad. But what was that about Labor Day?
What do you want?
Anyway. It reminds me of a joke, but I won't tell it here. It's too filthy. But anyway, so check it out. Thank you very, very much. We really, not only do we love playing here, the first gig we ever played outside of Boston was in Natick in Framingham. We played some kind of converted bowling alley. Some of you may remember that. And we played Michael's in Framingham. And this was the first area for us to play
when we first left Boston for the first time. Eventually, we played out in the Connecticut Valley out there at Amherst and UConn, and from there we became a national act and everything. But we always have great memories of this neighborhood, and Speen Street, Sandy McDonald had a recording studio there. We did a lot of stuff out there, so this is like a homecoming for us, and thank you very much. We had a wonderful time coming. So anyway, there's a song we had a lot of requests for. We never rehearsed it, but we'll give it a shot.
Thank you.
9:35. You be sitting down, trying to grab some eggs and bacon. And that train come by, your whole heart starts shaking. Cause it's Papa Train, Papa Train, Papa Train. Creeping up from the end of the tunnel. Gonna get right underneath your window and blow that whistle. Blow that whistle. Blow that whistle. Blow that whistle.
James Montgomery, ladies and gentlemen.